I'm Piper Wright, bringing you season 15 of the Panther Productions Holiday Special from Dilworth Plaza at Philadelphia City Hall. Here, people come from all around to check out local artists and get some gift shopping done. But enough about me and where I am. On today's show, you'll get to see tons of lights and storefront decorations, some interviews with CHS students, and a little entertainment news and baking instruction, and more. Stay tuned for a festive year with Panther Productions.
For the holidays, I would like a new bass guitar. It's pretty cool.
This year, I traveled to CHS Hall.
Here we have...
I'm here in front of Philadelphia's Christmas tree. Isn't it just amazing? Our first segment will be an informational video about holiday traditions in different cultures. Let's see what our expert CHS language teachers have to say about Christmas in France, Germany, and different Spanish-speaking countries.
The holidays are spent with friends and families celebrating traditions. We talked to the Collingswood High School teachers to see how the country of the language they teach celebrates the holidays.
So Christmas season actually begins back on December the 6th, which is called St. Nicholas Day. Maybe you've heard of some customs of putting shoes out, and then your shoes get filled up with candy and little toys and things. So that originated in Germany, and he also has a sidekick named Krampus, or in some places he's called Ruprecht. He's kind of his evil sidekick to make the bad little boys and girls, you know, be afraid that they're going to get coal or they're not going to get anything good. So the 24th, Christmas Eve, is actually a big deal for the Germans. So during the day, they're sort of preparing, they're getting all ready for it. And there's usually a church service at night, even though the Germans aren't overly religious anymore, but it's still part of their tradition. For the meal for Christmas, Germans often will have a roast goose or a roast duck. That tends to be pretty popular in most areas. Also in general in Germany during this time, they have lots of Christmas markets. You might know there's a big Christmas market over in Philadelphia by City Hall. That's inspired on the German-style Christmas markets. But having a Christmas tree in your house also originated from the Germans, too. So we do that. Or if you happen to know about the Advent wreath, counting down the four Christmas Sundays before Easter, also by having a wreath, and there's four candles in it, and they light a different candle each week, that also is a big German tradition. And then lastly, the Advent calendar. If you have the calendar, you open the little window up and you take a piece of chocolate out of it. That also began well over 100 years ago in Germany. So a lot of things we do are German, so I hope you enjoy it and you would enjoy your time in Germany doing that too. Thanks.
Okay, so a typical family in France will normally gather and celebrate on Christmas Eve, or in French it's called La Réveillon, and family members will gather together and they will have a very long meal. So it's actually called La Réveillon because it's in theory supposed to last very late and even into the next day, until Christmas Day. And they usually will have a beef dish of some kind and lots of food and lots of drinks and lots of talking and sitting and visiting. And they will end with a bûche de Noël, or a Yule log, which is a special chocolate flourless cake traditionally. And it's kind of a special holiday Christmas cake that many French families will make sure they have for the Christmas holidays, and they will also sing the chansons de Noël, which are Christmas carols. So kids will often grow up singing Christmas carols, much like students do here in the United States. And really, Christmas Eve is the big celebration in France specifically.
Right, like the big day is the 24th, which is Noche Buena. That's the day that we gather, we get together, we eat, party, dance. And usually at midnight, we exchange gifts. Some traditional dishes that we make, I'm Puerto Rican, so we make pasteles every year. We've been making them for many, many years. Similar to tamales, they're made of root vegetables, plátanos, and you ground them. Another thing that we make that's super traditional is coquito. People call it like Puerto Rican eggnog. It's a coconut drink. January 6th is the Three Kings Day. When I was little, that was my Christmas. That's the day that I would receive gifts. Instead of cookies and milk for Santa, we gather grass and water for the camels or horses that are bringing the Three Kings. So after the Three Kings Day, which is January 6th, we have Las Octavitas, which is 8 more days of just parties, celebration, and just being together with family.
It was really fun and informative learning about Christmas cultural traditions from our language teachers. This has been Amelia Trawl reporting for Panther Productions.
Who knew there were so many different ways to celebrate? Of course, there's ice skating like everyone's doing here. But speaking of celebration, coming close to the end of the year always marks a special celebration provided by Spotify to its users. Do you like music? Of course you do. We all do. But it seems like everyone's been listening to something different nowadays. For our next segment, let's listen to Amelia Trawl to see what CHS students were listening to this past year. It's time to expose some Spotify Wrapped.
Every year, Spotify sends us a recap of all the artists and songs we've listened to over the past year. This includes your top artist, top song, and even your top genre. This year, I traveled CHS hallways to find out what CHS students were listening to over the past year. What was your top song and your top artist?
So my top artist is Anderson .Paak, and the top song, Get This Money by Slum Village.
My top artist was Lil Uzi Vert, and my top song was 505.
Emma Hastings, what was your top song and your top artist?
It is Olivia Rodrigo and Favorite Crime by Olivia Rodrigo.
So what was your top song and top artist of 2022?
My top artist was Busy Banks, and my top song was Care by Sonder.
So Maddie, what was your top song and top artist?
My top artist was Electric Light Orchestra, and then my top song was Telephone Line by Electric Light Orchestra.
The Sound of Rain by God.
My top artist was Charlie XCX. My top song was Guy by Lady Gaga.
My top song was Panic Vertigo, and my top artist was The Rex.
My top artist is Keshi, and my top song is All Mine by Kanye West.
What was your top song or your top artist?
My top artist was Bakar, and my top song was First Time.
So what was your top song and top artist?
My top song was Ivy by Frank Ocean. My top artist was SZA.
My top artist was Taylor Swift, and my top song was I Think He Knows by Taylor Swift.
Top artist was The Weeknd, and my top song was Cowgirl Bebop by Hannah.
That was all for Collingswood High School Spotify Wrapped Recapped. A lot of cool artists and songs, if I do say so myself. I've been Amelia Trawl reporting for Panther Productions, and now back to Piper with your next segment.
Cool, now that was some interesting music. My top artist this year was Mount Joy, and my top song was Rearrange Us by Mount Joy. But of course, it's hard to beat live music. Now let's not forget, every winter, the choir, the orchestra, and the bands work hard to perform in the winter concert. We'll show you a couple of clips from the instrumental show now.
On December 15, 2022, the annual Collingswood High School Holiday Instrumental Concert was held. It included performances from both the middle and high school orchestras and bands. The concert would not be possible without the hard work of Mr. Lurch, Ms. Ludwig, and Mr. DeSantis. Let's take a moment to enjoy the music.
Thank you. beautiful music. I hope you all enjoyed this year's holiday concert. This is Abby Eimer reporting for Panther Productions.
On December 20th, 2022, Collingswood High School performed their annual holiday choral concert. Let's take a look at the high school's stellar performances directed by Mrs. Intercasa.
And I turn round and there you go, and Michael, you would fall and turn the white snow red as strawberries in the summertime. And you know, I was born from heaven. Did you know that your baby boy has walked the range of
The holiday season is in full swing, which means our wonderful town is decorated and lit up. This year makes the borough's second annual holiday house decorating competition. There are 22 houses split up amongst three categories: classic, most creative, and best block. How cool is that? What's even cooler is that I went around Collingswood to show off these holiday houses. Take a look.
You'll find Rudolph located on 108 East Madison Ave. Here we are at 451 Park Ave. Do the lights give anyone else Stranger Things vibes, or is that just me? We're here at 233 Crestmont Terrace. We've made our way to 742 Maple Ave just to see this Christmas tree with gifts underneath. Our next house is located at 135 Haddon Ave. 409 Ritchie Ave is the place to be. Look at those gold lights. I've made my way at 433 Collings Ave. I love this one because it's Eagles themed. I'm at 910 Stokes Ave. Talk about lights. Merrick Ave is where you'll find me. I don't know, something about this house just screams Christmas. I'm at 1037 Stokes Ave, spending some family time with my cousins. Just next door is 1033 Park Ave. This is a very classic home, if I do say so myself. Here we are on 134 Crestmont Terrace. If I'm quiet, you can hear the music in the back. Six 19 Stokes Ave is where you'll find Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, Santa, and that guy. Just a few houses down is 437 Park Ave. Look at those nutcrackers, they're glowing. If you come to 432 Virginia Ave, you'll spot some friends like Yoda and Darth Vader. Next up, 433 Calmley Ave. Look at those icicles, don't they look so realistic? And our last stop in this category is 112 Cooper Ave. This probably has to be the cutest house I've seen. Look at those penguins, just having fun. The first walk I'll be showing is 101 to 120 East Madison Ave.
The first street I went to felt so comforting. It's what I imagine in Christmas movies, and a special appearance was made by baby Jesus.
The next block I'll be showing you is 100 to 120 East Narberth Terrace.
This street did not disappoint, to say the least. It was lit up from top to bottom. There were even lights on the trees.
This block is 204 to 223 Ritchie Ave.
I love this street because of all the little inflatable Christmas figures. Very on brand. Now that you've had a good look at all the houses, it's time to announce the winners. The winner of Classic House goes to 108 East Madison Ave. The winner of Most Creative goes to 432 Virginia Ave. And last but certainly not least, the winner of Best Block goes to 100 Block East Narberth. Congratulations to those three, and a big round of applause for all houses that contributed.
I think we can all agree every house was spectacular. What was your favorite?
If I had to pick, it would have to be the one on 793 Merrick Ave. Well, I had an amazing time showing off every house, and I look forward to next year's Holiday House Decorating Contest here at Collinswood. I've been Brittany Lopez reporting for Panther Productions. Now back to our anchors in the studio.
Wow, those are some dedicated competitors. It takes a lot of work and electricity to really deck out a house like that. So props to all those in the competition. Next up, have you noticed all the displays in the businesses downtown? The toy trains, fake snow, and big bows? If you haven't, you're about to. Let's watch our reporters, Mimi Emmons and Jake Roseborough's ranking of the top 10 storefront decorations on Haddon Ave.
Hi, I'm Jake Roseborough from Panther Productions around here on Haddon Avenue. Today, we're going to be looking at the best and brightest holiday displays that Collinswood has to offer. Let's get festive. First off, we're going to be looking at the Collinswood building, and it has a collaborative display of lights across all storefronts. As you can see on the top, it has more orangey and blue lights that look very, very good. And the candy canes in front of the calligraphy store are a really nice touch. I like that it all kind of has a theme together, even though each of the stores get their own personality. I'm going to give it a 9 out of 10.
First up, we have Bespoke on Haddon Ave. I like their more gift-wrapped approach. I think that they use a more simplistic stuff to make a more eye-pleasing experience. I think that if I was walking by this store, I would definitely want to go into it, and that is mainly because of their display outside. I'm going to give this one a 10 out of 10. And then we have the Occasionette Joy Shop. Obviously, with this store, I feel like we were expecting a lot of creativity, and that's what we got. So many colors, so much thought put into this one. I really like the Christmas tree at the center with all of the pom-poms on it. It gives more of like an arts and crafts style, which again, is what this store is, so I think that really works. Maybe not my absolute favorite, but I do really like it. I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10. This is Revolution Coffee, and I really like their display. I think it really captures a winter wonderland feel. I like the trees, especially with the coffee bean gingerbread man. I think it was a very nice display, and I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10. I really like what Extraordinary Ed did here with the presents and the giant bear. It really feels like a Christmas morning where you're just getting a mound of presents, and that really works with the theme of their store and what they're trying to sell you. It works really well with kids. I just think this is a perfect holiday display, and I'm gonna give it a 10 out of 10. This is the town newspaper, AKA The Retrospect, and what else would you expect from them? It's a really, really homey kind of feel. It really represents the community well, and I think the more vintage Christmas really, really works, and I don't have much else to say other than that, so I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10. Here we have Songbird Karaoke, and I think this one is absolutely beautiful. It's not great because the other side has some lights off, but this side is very gorgeous. It has really cool decorations. It seems like it has a lot of detail going into it, and it has a menorah right there, which is always great. We always love inclusivity. This is going to get a 9 out of 10, really solid. here we have the absolute crowning achievement of Haddon Ave. This is by far my favorite window display. It just perfectly encapsulates what you would want from a Christmas display. It has all of our favorite characters from stop motion animated films, and it just is Christmas. This is what Christmas is to me, or the holiday season, and I'm going to give it a 10 out of 10, the best one we've seen so far. Finally, we have the Kitchen Consigliere. This is an Italian restaurant on Haddon Ave, and they went for the classic approach. These are like the lights and the Christmas trees, and it works really, really well, and I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10.
Although we have to pick a winner, every display was great in its own right. My absolute favorite has to be the hardware store with its figurine display. This is Jake from Panther Productions. Happy holidays, everyone.
Geez, Jake was a tough judge. They were all pretty impressive, though. Like this view. Go and visit these local businesses in the holiday season if you haven't already, and maybe get some gift shopping done. Everyone knows gifts are a major part of the holidays, especially when it comes to scramble for everyone's presents or figuring out what you want for your own wish list. What gift are you hoping for the most? Our reporters Abby Eimer and Nicole Lewandowski went out into CHS halls to see what students were crossing their fingers for this year. Let's have a look.
As the holiday season begins, many students and staff are creating holiday gift wish lists. Let's hear what gifts CHS is hoping for this year.
What do you want for the holidays?
A snowboard.
A Tatcha skincare set.
I want a double glass coffee mug because I think they're really cute.
What do you want for the holidays this year?
I want jewelry because I feel like I don't have any.
I probably want a tennis racket because mine is almost like the strings are pretty shot. And with tennis season coming up, I need a new one.
For the holidays, I would really like Arabian perfume because it lasts longer than a lot of American perfumes and you smell good all day.
I want a Skims dress for Christmas.
For the holidays, I would like a new bass guitar. It'd be pretty cool.
I want a new laptop for Christmas because the laptop I have is like 10 years old and it doesn't work anymore.
Having my family around me because my brother's coming back from Arizona after 6 years.
I want a corkboard so I can, you know how detectives have like the pictures? I can figure out crimes in our local area.
Thank you to everyone who participated. I hope you all get what you're hoping for. This is Maddox Morfatai reporting for Panther Productions.
Hello, I'm Michael Tanier with Pause TV, and today we're going to be looking at the top 5 games to buy for your family this Christmas. Now, this will be a list of games not to buy for yourself, but more of a list of entry-level games to buy for people whose taste in games you aren't necessarily sure about. So, yeah. Number 5, Cult of the Lamb. Despite the name, Cult of the Lamb is a great game that I believe most people could play and enjoy. Despite it being a roguelike, which is a rather niche genre, it's not particularly complex or difficult, and between that and its cutesy art style, it's a great entry-level game in the genre and a very accessible game in general. It's not too hard, it's fun, and it's cute. Anyone can really enjoy this one. Or God of War Ragnarok. Now, truth be told, I'm not the biggest fan of this game, but the problems I have with it are also the things that make it a great game to get for people who aren't the biggest gamers. The game feels very much like an interactive movie, with its story being told through cutscenes and cinematics, and the gameplay being a simple but satisfying hack and slash experience. The game is essentially an action movie where you play through the fight scenes, and while I don't like that, many people will. This is a perfect gift to get for, say, a dad who takes a passing interest in gaming. Number 3, Mario vs. Rabbids: The Sparks of Hope. Okay, I'm gonna be straight with all of you, this game series is one of the most cursed things in existence. It's a crossover between the Mac Daddy of gaming and the most annoying little turds in the entire gaming industry. This is like if Disney made a new movie about Mickey Mouse and then had the Minions show up halfway through. What's even more confusing is the way this crossover is handled. When you think of Mario, what do you think of? That's right, jumping. And when I think of the Rabbits, what comes to mind for me, other than Eternal Damnation, is mini-games. Well, Mario has a ton of party games, so you think that Mario vs. Rabbids would be one of those, right? Wrong! It's XCOM! Yep. Mario vs. Rabbids is a turn-based strategy game with a focus on ranged combat and cover shooting. Okay, you know what? As long as the game is good, it's fine, and arguably the worst part out of all of this is that they are good. They, as in plural. There are multiple Mario Minions XCOM games, and they are good! Look, it's good for kids, I just want to stop thinking about this thing. Number 2, Stray. Stray is a perfect game to buy this Christmas for the sole reason that it's a game that literally anyone can enjoy. It's a game about a cat. It's not exactly an acquired taste. It's not hard, it's not stressful, it's cute, and it's visually and audiologically appealing. Number 1, Kirby and the Forgotten Land. It's Kirby. There isn't really much to say. Kirby's newest outing is fully 3D, and it's incredible. Probably the best Kirby has ever been. It's fun, it's cute, and it's a game literally anyone can enjoy. More than any other game on this list, I recommend you buy this game for your family this Christmas.
Those are some good gift ideas. I hope their parents or Santa are watching. I think the gift I'm hoping for most this year is a Polaroid camera. But of course, I'd be grateful for everything. Something else I'm grateful for in this winter season is the seasonal treats. There's nothing like a good cookie or a gingerbread house. Our beloved anchor, Enzo DeMasi, and his dad, Mr. DeMasi, have an amazing holiday recipe to share with us. So let's go to the DeMasi kitchen to see what they're cooking up.
Hi, I'm Jeff DeMasi. I'm going to show you my grandmother, or my nanny's, Angeletti recipe. The first thing I'm going to do is cream the butter. Going to add some sugar now to cream the butter, half a cup. Okay, the next step is to add the eggs. What I love about this recipe is it doesn't really have that anywhere except in the ingredient list that there's 5 eggs. Add in the 4.5 cups of flour, 2 tablespoons of baking powder, and 3 teaspoons of vanilla. Now the 2 teaspoons of baking powder. Next I have to turn out the dough. The next step is to pinch off a walnut-sized piece of dough, roll it between your hands, and wrap it around your finger like a ring. Now they go in the oven for 15 minutes at 350 degrees, or until lightly browned.
Starting now.
While you're baking, it's a good time to make the icing, which is powdered sugar, vanilla, and some milk. There's no real instructions in the recipe on the consistency you want, but I just know. All right, when it's after 15 minutes and it's golden brown, take them out of the oven, and put them over here. And the next step is actually, while they're still hot, to ice them. I have this tray set up here. And it's nice to have a second pair of hands to put the sprinkles on them while they're still hot. The icing is still hot. These are hot, but I can handle it because my fingers can deal with this crazy heat. But this is a little bit tricky. Now for the real test, see how they taste while they're still hot. Oh wow. I think this might be the best one I've ever done. Hope you and your family have a great holiday season.
Geez, my mouth is watering after that segment. The Angeletti's looked so good, and I might have to grab a bite to eat at that bratwurst stand. You know what else looks good? The new Avatar movie coming out. Avatar, The Way of the Water. I'm a big fan of the first movie, so this is pretty exciting for me. Audrey Wozniak went to the premiere at AMC Theaters to see what people had to say about this new release. Don't worry, no spoilers, of course, just lots of different opinions.
Though the 2009 movie Avatar doesn't seem like it's talked about much in discussions of pop culture, the film, famous for its blue characters, is actually the highest-grossing movie of all time. Known for its groundbreaking visual effects, it seems like the new sequel, Avatar, The Way of Water, has big shoes to fill. Let's head over to the local premiere and see what opinions people have to share.
Hi, my name is Charlotte Bosniak. I'm reporting for WCHS Pulse TV outside of AMC Theaters in Cherry Hill, and I'm going to be asking people about Avatar, The Way of Water. What are your expectations going in to see this movie?
Honestly, they're really big. I know that the franchise has been spread out, so like they're taking their time to really put some work into these movies, and I'm expecting something huge.
We just came back from Disney and we did the Avatar ride. We want to be in the ride in this movie.
I think it's going to be pretty good. It's pretty long, but I'll give it a chance.
I expect it to be a very visually pleasing movie, like in terms of the technical level.
Oh, I would really want to see the effects at first. That's the reason why I chose the theaters.
Well, it's a day early than the actual release, so
I think it's going to be fun.
Did you see the first one, and did you like the first one?
Saw it, loved it, had some notes, so I'm hoping this one just blows it out of the water.
What, did you see the first one, and did you like it?
I loved it so much. Like, I just rewatched it again, just the other day.
Did you see the first movie?
No.
These interviewees have just come out of the movie, so let's see what they have to say.
So, what were your expectations going in to see this movie?
I was super excited. This has been going on for over a decade. We've been waiting for the movie, and I love James Cameron, so I was really excited.
I liked it a lot more than I thought I was going to, and I'm excited to see like the next four, like, whatever he's going to do.
My expectations was it had better been the best movie that ever been made because it took so long to come out.
I was expecting it to be good, but I was not expecting it to be that. Like, that...
What would you rate it out of 10?
It was a 10. Like, I mean, half of the movie I was like bawling.
It was good. It was really good.
Were your expectations met?
It was met halfway.
What would you rate it out of 10 now that you've seen it?
10. 11.
I'd go 8 out of 10. I have some issues. It's probably because it was a very emotional movie.
Out of 10?
Yeah, 10 out of 10. It's the theatrical experience. It's got to live on. James Cameron is helping it live on.
I'll give it an 8 out of 10.
I give it a 9.
Out of 10, maybe like a 8.5.
Oh, don't, like, get your hopes up too high.
Oh, my God. I loved it. Absolutely.
What would you rate it out of 10?
I'd give it a 9.
I've been Charlotte Bosniak reporting for WCHS Pause TV, interviewing about Avatar, The Way of Water. I hope you guys all enjoyed.
Wasn't that cool? A big thanks to all of our interviewees. If you like the first Avatar, definitely see this new one. Just maybe bring a diaper, considering it's a whopping 3 hours and 12 minutes. Up next, everyone knows the world of sports doesn't stop for the holidays. Quadir White has a segment for us on sports everyone is watching this winter season. Let's have a look now.
This year for Christmas, there will be NFL and NBA action going on. Next, the Dallas Mavericks versus the LA Lakers from Los Angeles. Boston Celtics versus the Milwaukee Bucks. Memphis Grizzlies versus the Golden State Warriors.
Now for football, we have some great matchups like the Dolphins versus the Packers, Rams versus Broncos, Tampa Bay Buccaneers versus the Arizona.
Tune into some NBA, NFL, and NCAA bowl games over the break if you can. Now, our final video of the show. Max Roseborough is coming to us from the Reindeer Run. This event is charitable, with all proceeds going to the Collingswood Panther Pantry. I don't love running, but some people do, and that is just great. Let's meet some of those people now.
On December 17th, the Collingswood Panther Pantry held the Reindeer Run, which includes a 3-mile run or a 1-mile walk.
I'm Josh Forrest. I graduated in 2021 from Collingswood High School. I'm running today just to be out here with my dad and my little brother who are also running.
I mean, I'm just running this to support the team. And I mean, I thought it would be a fun thing to do. Just, you know, I needed to run anyway today. So that's why I'm out here.
I'm looking forward to seeing the remaining leaves on the trees and on the ground. And I'm looking forward to for the money to go to a good cause.
Let's go, Miss Madden!
What's your name?
Elijah Forrest.
How was that race?
A pretty good race. I was at the end time for a little bit. They went a little ahead. We got to meet them Monday, so.
Word.
Not taking this too hard, but we're both super, super thankful to be here to support in the Panther Pantry.
Do you think it was your best time for a 3K?
Definitely not, because I wasn't going all out.
Do you think the weather affected your running?
Well, my hat was blowing off all the time.
Right,
After the race, runners got to warm up with some hot chocolate. I want to wish everyone a happy holiday and stay safe.
That was a look at the local 5K, and boy did it look cold. But thanks to all of the runners for supporting a good cause. Now, unfortunately, this was our last segment together and I'm back in Collingswood, but I've had a wonderful time sharing this holiday season with you. Have a Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, lovely Kwanzaa, Happy New Year, and a relaxing holiday break. Pulse TV thanks you so much for tuning into our show, and we'll see you next year.